For this project, actually I'm using three different colors and have just decided like to play around with them and to be able to create three different versions of granny square. As you can see, all these granny squares, they have the same color, but have just decided like to layer them in a different way. And you must not be limited to these colors, or try to layer them the same way I have layered mine. You can just stick to one way of layering your color until you are done with your granny squares, or you can play with two of them, or anyway, whatever way you prefer, you can just go ahead and do that. So without further ado, we can just begin. With a 3.25mm crochet hook, just make a magic ring like this first. Insert the hook inside like this while holding the other side tight. Chain one. Now make 3 double crochet in this magic ring. Once you get 3 double crochet in the magic ring, chain one, that's your first corner. Make 3 more double crochet in this magic ring. Chain one again and keep pulling this yarn a bit. That's your second corner. Make more 3 double crochet in this magic ring. Just continue doing that until you have a total of 4 corners. In between each corner, there should be three double crochet stitches. First corner, second corner. Chain one again to create the third corner. Like that. And just keep on pulling this one. Do not let it go. One, two, three. Now to create the last corner, just chain one and you can insert the hook on top of the first double crochet like this. Slip stitch to join, chain one and you can cut off the yarn. And don't forget to pull this yarn that's under like this. Just pull it tight. Cut off the yarn because we are switching to a different yarn color. Next, make a slip knot. Start in any chain one space. Chain one, make 3 double crochet in that same space, which is actually chain one space. Make 3 double crochet into the next chain one space. And just keep on bringing this yarn tail. Do not leave it behind. Since you are trying to create your second corner here, this is your first corner, but you're going to complete it end of this round or row. Now chain two. Make more 3 double crochet in that same space. Also remember, you must bring this yarn that's under like this. Just bring it along. Now make 3 double crochet, make another corner in this next chain one space the same way you have done here. Make 3 first double crochet, chain 2 and 3 more double crochet into that same space to create your third corner. Three more double crochet. And just repeat that into the next space all the way until you reach the last space here, then I will meet you to show you the next step. Once you are done with your first 3 corners completed, now you have to complete this last corner. Remember, you have only made 3 first double crochet. Now make more 3 double crochet in this first space. Chain 2. Slip stitch on top of the first double crochet. Like that. chain one and you can cut off the yarn because you are switching to a different yarn color again. For the third color, just make a slip knot the same way you have done for the previous color and start in one of the corner like that. Chain one, make 3 double crochet in this first corner. It's an incomplete corner which we are going to complete at the end of this round. Make 3 double crochet into the next space. It's not a corner, so you have just to make 3 double crochet and proceed to the next corner. Make 3 double crochet into the next corner. Remember, it's a corner, so you have to make the first 3 double crochet, chain 2 and 3 more double crochet into the same space to complete the corner. Make 3 double crochet into the next space and just continue doing that all the way until you are done. Into the last corner, you must just make the 3 double crochet the same way you've done for the previous row. 3 double crochet, chain 2, then slip stitch on top of the first double crochet to complete. Then chain 1, you can cut off the yarn. Then I'll meet you to show you the next step. So just go ahead and finish with this color. I'll meet you once we are done to show you the next step. For the next row, we are going to switch back to the first color we have started with, and we're just going to start the same way by making a slip knot and just repeat the previous row. Start always in one of the corner and make the first 3 double crochet to make that first corner incomplete, so you can complete it later, just like that. Make the first 3 double crochet in here. Make 3 double crochet into the next space. You are just repeating the previous row. Make 3 double crochet into the next space. Just that the more you are adding more rows and or rounds, the more spaces there will be in between these corners. So make the first 3 double crochet in this corner. Chain 2. Make 3 more double crochet in this corner to complete your corner. Into the next space, make the make 3 double crochet. And just continue doing that all the way until you come here. Once you come here, always remember you must place the first 3 double crochet, chain 2, then slip stitch on top of this very first double crochet, the same way we have done for other previous rows. You can cut out the yarn, then next I'll meet you to show you how you're going to switch to this other color. Actually, you're just going to switch to this other color the same way we have switched to all other colors, because this is the last color that you're going to have for this granny square. Or if you want your granny squares to be small, you can just end it here. Or if you want them to be big, then you can keep on adding more rows and rows. The reason I'm using 3 different colors and dealing them different like this, I want my granny squares to be a little bit colorful. So just go ahead and complete this. Then you must complete this granny square with the next color, which is must be this next color for the next for the second row. Or any way you prefer to layer your colors. So once you are done, this is how your granny square must be looking like. Just go ahead and do the same to other granny squares.